Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. My name is Lily and I'm a voice teacher and performance coach based out of Canada. Thank you so much for joining me today. Today is a really, really exciting day because we're getting back into my series of reacting to season one of High School Musical, the musical, the series. I know it's been a hot minute, but we are back right in it. I have finished all of season four, and if you haven't watched those yet and you are caught up to date with the show, please go and watch those videos because they were so fun to make and I love doing the reactions in real time. This is only because I got into High School Musical, the series so late is why I'm reacting to them now, but better late than never, right? In today's video, we are getting into the songs featured on season one, episode five, Homecoming, and episode six, What Team. Now, these episodes both had very few songs, so I thought I'd combine them just to get you a decent sized video with just enough songs to react to and just good time fun. Good time fun? Yeah, that's what we're going with today. So that's what we will be getting into in today's video. But before I get into any reacting today, I just want to say a huge thank you to all of you. Yes, you. All of you who subscribe, and if you're not, you should subscribe to the channel, and who watch, and who comment, who like, who do all the great things to, you know, keep this channel growing. I really appreciate you. And like I mentioned, if you're not already subscribed and you like what you're seeing, or you've seen a video of mine in the past, or you like High School Musical, the musical, the series, or you like Voice Teacher Reacts content, you should click subscribe and also the post notifications button so you can get notified every single time I upload a new video. You should do it right now. Go for it right now. I'll wait for you. Don't worry. All right, let's get into it. Okay, so we start episode five. This is the homecoming episode, which in the lore of High School Musical, the musical, the series, this is kind of an iconic episode because this has the scene with Gina and Ricky, which is referenced later, which if you know, you know. But the only song that was actually featured in this episode as like a sung song with lyrics was Born to Be Brave, which is a wonderful original song made for the show. So the preamble to this moment is that Nini is been having issues with EJ and also Ricky, and just like she doesn't want to go to homecoming because she just doesn't want to go to homecoming and see these people. So her and Courtney agreed to go out on a girls' night on the town with Miss Jen, which low-key very weird behavior, but I guess we're just gonna go with it. And Courtney and Nini sing this song in the parking lot of the bowling alley because Nini's too afraid to sing it at karaoke. I don't know, it was kind of a weird moment in time. I don't really understand what was going on there, but and also it overlaps with a scene in the homecoming dance where Carlos is upset because Seb is late to the dance. He asked Seb to go and he said yes, but Seb is late, so he thinks he's being stood up. And he just wants to dance with a dance partner. He just wants to dance. And Mr. Ma, is it Mazara? Mazara? I kept calling him Maserata, and I don't think that's actually his name. I think it's Mazara. He convinces Carlos to dance on his own, which is what Carlos does at the start of the song, and then other people join him as the song progresses. So regardless, we're getting into the cast of High School Musical, the musical, the series, singing Born to Be Brave. This is such a wild experience because I literally just watched the cast in season four sing Born to Be Brave there as like the final scene. Well, one of the final songs that they sing. So it's just such a whiplash moment to be going back to this song. But let's get into it.
Don't need a king. I got my crown.
Don't oh my God, baby Courtney.
Built this heart, it's beating loud, won't let no bad blood ever bring us down.
Okay, I have to say, this is the beginning of Courtney as a singer on the show, right? We haven't heard her sing at this point, really. And it's really nice to see it. It's really fun to see it. And we're not quite there with like how Courtney brings this like unique style to her verses later on, but you can see the little, it's starting, it's like simmering, but soon we'll get the full Courtney experience and I'm so ready for it. I'm so excited.
Keep flying higher, fly like a fire. What if I'm
that was such an interesting riff from Courtney, just because the approach was like not what I'm used to hearing from her. I feel like if she were to sing that like today, it would be a bit more belty, in your face, loud, whereas this was a little like held back, a little more like of a lighter mix for Courtney, which even then, it's still pretty powerful. So that was just interesting to note. And it's hard for me to not put in my perspective of these singers how they are now, just because of this information that I have. So it's just really, it's really fun to watch these episodes and see like how these singers have progressed over the years. It's really, really cool. Oh, Carlos. Why are we doing a toddler two-step right now? All right. I forgot to mention this earlier. I don't believe that Courtney and Nini are a good duet pairing. And I will say why. Very different voices here, you know? Like, Courtney is big, bombastic, like really in your face. And then Nini still can hold her own presence. Like, I think that the song is great in its own right. I just think that Nini does not have the power to match with Courtney. Like, I feel like we either need Nini to do more or Courtney to do less in order for it to be like a better balance. So. I used to feel like I was low. That's such a silly line. It's like my phone's navigation was turned off. This is, I remember watching this the first time. I was like, okay, that's a little, it's a little cringe. I stumbled on, that led me right to the place where I belong. Keep flying. Really interesting to hear like Olivia Rodrigo's sound change over the years as well. She's matured a lot as a singer, so it's really interesting. She's a little more like, for lack of a better word, immature in this. She definitely sounds like a kid, which is great and honestly works for the show at this point. So it's just really interesting to hear her stuff now, and I'm like, oh, there's just such a difference. Very interesting, very cool. Me and Carlos dancing together.
I actually kind of feel bad for the guy.
So dance with him. Be involved. Ashlyn is good. Like, why is Idris like, I feel bad for the guy? Why don't you do something? Why don't you participate in making him feel better? EJ is such a weird character in season one. It's so weird seeing him like this at this point. That's a fun breakdown. Ooh, dancing, choreography. Ooh! That slide forward, such a great choreography moment. Ooh, backwards. We did like a wave, like the wave. Ooh, that was so fun. I really love too when I can see like the main cast members keeping up with the choreography of the like the featured extras or like the background dancers. Like, I love seeing that because sometimes there's such a disconnect. I'm like, you were clearly hired for a specific reason, and these people were clearly hired for a specific reason, but there's no, we're not connecting the two.
What a fun song.
Literally, Big Red is a dancer. Like, the actor is a tap dancer and, like, very, very good. Why is he not dancing right now? And they gave me wings to fly to my castle. Come on, DJ. Imagine you go to your high school dance and you're like, just, they lift you up in the air, like lying back. Imagine that happened to you, your high school dance. Whose high school experience is that, you know? Who had that high school experience? Because it definitely wasn't me. Like castles in the sky. Cute. What a fun song. It was always such a bop, such a good time. The singers really held their own. I will say, like, I'm pretty sure it's more like Courtney Nene focused. Maybe correct me if I'm wrong. It's a really fun song with lots of energy, and it really incorporates the whole cast, which is always fun to watch. Really, really a great song, and I'm happy to revisit it. All right, now we are getting into episode 6, What Team? And at this point in time, Miss Jen has had some bad news that, you know, she has fudged some credits on her resume, and the school board has found out and are going to do like a, not a hearing, but a meeting of some sort, and she could get fired. So Miss Jen asks Carlos to not tell anybody because nothing is definite. No decisions have been made at this point. So Carlos decides to proceed with rehearsal as normal, but is just unable to get a hold of the cast and is feeling overwhelmed. So he ends up revealing Miss Jen's secret, which, not a great move, and everyone leaves rehearsal because they're like, well, how are we going to put on a show without our drama teacher? So at this point, when this song comes up, which is Joshua Bassett as the character of Ricky singing When There Was Me and You, which is a song from High School Musical, him and Gina have kind of stuck around after everyone has left, and I think she asked him to sing this or something. I don't know. It comes up somehow. So this is Joshua Bassett singing When There Was Me and You. I love when he plays guitar. I thought you were my fairy tale, my dream when I'm not sleeping, a wish upon a star that's coming true. Oh my gosh. They are so young. It is crazy how young they look. Oh my gosh. And everybody else could tell that I confused my feelings with the truth. There was me and you. Oh. It's very interesting to watch Joshua Bassett sing this song because it's not like the original. Joshua Bassett is able to do a lot more than Zac Efron was vocally, so he's adding his own uniqueness to the song by just incorporating more riffs. It also modernizes the song, which is really, really cool to see. So let's listen to more. I'm only left with used to be's and once upon a song. Now I know you're not a fairy tale, and dreams are meant for sleeping, and wishes on a star just don't come true. Like, that was really nice. True. Pretty. Very nice. Cause now even I can tell that I confuse my feelings with the truth. Cause I like the view. He likes the view. When there was me and you. That was very sweet. Very much a short and sweet number. Really cute. Really got the message across that Ricky's now in love with Gina. Because obviously, no. It's really nice to see Ricky sing. I always love seeing Joshua Bassett sing. Come on. And like I mentioned, just seeing him incorporate his own things into the song to make it his own, but also to show off his own vocals that are just not featured in the original song, because the original song is just a bit more simple. There's nothing wrong with that, but he's just able to do so much more. So he is showing us that. And I love that he was playing live guitar. It all sounds really nice and fun. And it's just a really nice way to, again, show off the talent of these young individuals at this point, because they are so young and new. Well, maybe not new to the craft, but like at this point to the world, we don't really know who they are. And they're just so talented. And I love seeing their talent being showcased. Okay. We are on to the final song of today's reaction, which is Truth, Justice, and Songs Anarchy. This is an interesting song. So at this point, we are at the hearing, I don't think that's what it's called, but for Miss Jen, and the drama kids decide to come up with a song in order to save Miss Jen's job because they love her so much and they want her to keep being the drama teacher at East High. So they create the song and they perform it at the meeting. So let's get into it. The humming. What's that? This is the most intense humming I've ever seen in my life.
Don't say another word. Some of us need to be heard.
That start with Courtney was awesome. Just so fun. Also, the boombox over her head. So funny.
You want her big confession.
Ooh,
she never saw dear Evan Hansen. Whatever you think about her, the show can't go on without her.
Ooh, those two voices are really nice together, and we never hear them. Ashlyn and Ricky. I would love to hear them more, but you know, we don't have that opportunity anymore, unfortunately.
Maybe her class could be a little more classy.
Maybe her head's not in the game.
I love the harmony there.
Maybe her past is just a little bit sketchy.
Carlos with this, like, maybe her past is a little bit sketchy. We just got a little bit too much enunciation going on there, which, depending on the context, could work. I think it worked fine here. I think that's not a habit I would advise him to do moving forward.
We need her all the same.
The dancing.
She's the one who cheers us on. So what if she's dropping the ball?
I love Joe Serafini. I want to hear him more.
She stands for truth, justice, and songs in our key. She stands for us and we believe.
Yeah.
Before she got here, we were so off track. And Miss Jen gave us a chance.
Oh my god, young Gina too singing. Wow, very interesting. Ricky is such an interesting character to me because he always talks about how, like, you know, he didn't sing before. He joined the drama club and was like, you know, he found this community within the drama program. I'm like, there's no way you never sang before, dude. You have a great voice. And you definitely heard that, like, in your life before the drama club. Come on, come on.
We used to fall asleep in chemistry class.
Now it makes us want to dance.
Great harmony. Great four-part harmony. That was really cool. Whoever sang the makes us want to dance. Really cool part.
He's the show that must go on. So
we never hear her sing. What the heck? Oh my gosh.
Putting in a good word because we heard.
She stands for truth, justice, and songs in our key. She stands for us and we believe.
Motivation. Break it down.
She provides the inspiration. Whatever about her reputation. Seems about time for modulation.
All right, let's pause. Do you ever think about the context of this song? They're like, we don't care that maybe her past is a little like, we love her all the same and she is great. This would never fly in real life. This would never fly. I love how just not real this is. I love it. I love it. It's so silly. Oh, yes. Let's go, dancers. I love them. The principal's so mad. I'm mad, but mad. Miss Jen joins in.
She stands for us and we.
is the goofiest song ever, you guys. This is so goofy. I forgot. This is so silly. What a silly song. I will say I love all the voices in High School Musical, the musical, the series. They're always like so well done. They're so diverse, and I just love how diverse the cast is. Not everyone sounds the same, and that's okay. That's what we want. That is real. That is authentic. That is how it should be. And I really love that this cast was always so diverse. I just love that about the show. All right, everybody. Well, that was me reacting to the songs featured in High School Musical, the musical, the series, season 1, episodes 5 and 6. If you liked what you saw today and you would like to see more, please subscribe to my channel and turn on the post notifications button so you can get notified every single time I upload a new video. You can follow me on my social media channels, which will be linked down below. And hey, if you're interested in some lessons or some advice on your voice, you are more than welcome to reach out to me directly for lesson inquiries on my Instagram page, which again will be linked down below. All right, everybody, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!